Hello and welcome to Off-Grid News, our take on the on-grid world. This time, tiny homes, the big picture. The average size of a new house in America has nearly doubled since the 1950s, according to the National Association of Home Builders. New single-family homes grew from 1,800 square feet in 1978 to 2,500 square feet in 2007, despite a decrease in the size of the average family. Reasons for this include material wealth and so-called prestige. Then came the Great Recession, and downsizing was the order of the day. You might have bought a traditional home 10 years ago for $125,000, but still owe $125,000 on it. You could have bought a tiny home for $35,000 and put it on some land, instead of buying a little house in a neighborhood and still owing the same amount. Alternatively, parents who are sending their kids to university could buy a tiny home and put it in a campground. As a bonus, if Junior doesn't get a job on graduation, at least he won't be moving back home. The small house movement is a return to houses less than 1,000 square feet, some as small as 80 square feet. Smaller homes are less expensive than larger ones in terms of taxes and building, heating, maintenance, and repair costs. In addition to costing less, small houses encourage a less cluttered and simpler lifestyle and reduce ecological impacts by their inhabitants. The typical size of a small home seldom exceeds 500 square feet, and the typical tiny house on wheels is less than 8 by 20 feet, with a livable space totaling 120 square feet or less, for ease of towing and to exempt it from the need for a building permit. In the USA in 2005, after Hurricane Katrina, Marianne Cusato developed Katrina cottages that start at 308 square feet.
The idea of the Katrina cottage is that we can build houses that look great, but also are built sturdy.
Though these were created to provide a pleasant solution to a disaster zone, Cusato received wider interest in her design from resort developers, for example. With the financial crisis of 2007, the small house movement attracted more attention as it offers housing that is affordable in acquisition and maintenance. Overall, however, it represents a very small part of real estate transactions. Only 1% of home buyers acquire houses of 1,000 square feet or less. They are also used as accessory dwelling units, known as ADUs, to serve as additional on-property housing for aging relatives or returning children, or as a home office or a guest house. Typical costs are about $20,000 to $50,000 as of 2013. Interest in very small homes has been revived in other countries as well. For example, in Japan, where space is at a premium, Takaharu Tezuka built the House to Catch the Sky in Tokyo, a 925 square foot home for four. In Barcelona, Spain, Eva Prats and Ricardo Flores presented the 300 square foot House in a Suitcase. In England, Abito created Intelligent Living Spaces apartments of 353 square feet in Manchester. In Germany, British architect Richard Horton and the Technical University of Munich developed the Micro Compact Home, also known as MCH, a high-end 76 square foot cube designed for one or two people with functional spaces for cooking, hygiene, dining, working and sleeping. Small and tiny houses have received increasing media coverage, including a TV show, Tiny House Nation, coming July 7th, 2014. The possibility of building one's own home has fueled the movement, particularly for tiny houses on wheels, similar to RVs, but built to last as long as traditional homes. However, unlike traditional homes, tiny houses on wheels do not require building permits. This increase in the popularity of tiny houses, and particularly the rapid increase in the number of both amateur and professional builders, has led to safety concerns among professionals. In 2013, a Tiny House Building Alliance was formed to address ethical and safety issues. But the tiny homes movement has a deeper significance than physical size or money saving. It's about redefining the American dream to value quality over quantity. People seem to forget that there's a big world outside the front door of your home. As Americans in suburban America, we spend a lot of time in our homes. But there are libraries, parks, sidewalks, cafes, and small spaces encourage people to get out more. So avoid a fat mortgage to pay off for the next 30 years. Don't dream of a mansion. Live a humble, simple life in the burbs or in the mountains with a small roof over your head and the world as your living room. It's a truly wonderful and achievable ambition.